Hello, I'm Luis Contreras and I'm going to talk about why violence video games contribute to youth violence here in America. This is my audience. As many of you might know, 97% of US kids between 12 and 17 years old play video games, contributing to the millionaire industry of video games. Also, taking into consideration that the top games in the market contain violence. And also, violence in video games has been blamed for school shootings, increasing bullying, and violence in towards women. I'm going to talk about playing video games causes more aggression towards women, and also fighting. The second point is gonna be a violent video game that sensitizes players to real life violence. And my third point is gonna be many of perpetrators of school shootings used to play video games. Okay, my first point. 60% of middle school boys and 40% of middle school girls who play at least immature games can beat up someone in a fight, or compared to the 39% of boys and 14% of girls who do not play the immature games, you can see the comparison between both. A 2014 study showed that in Journal of the American Medical Association found that habitual violent video games playing had a link with increase in aggressive behavior. Also, another study showed that playing video games are more likely the children to bully and be aggressive throughout their school year. My second point, violence, video games can desensitize players to real life violence. What do I mean by that? Desensitization to violence was defined in a journal of experimental social psychological as a reduction in emotion related to real violence. The study showed that in just 20 minutes of playing video games can cause a more aggressive behavior in your brain unconsciously to children. Just by the age of 18, American children will have seen 16,000 murders and 200,000 acts of violence in their life. And also, a 2011 study found a causal link between video games and exposure can increase their aggression in their self. And my third point is gonna be of the many perpetrators of the shooting in a school used to play video games while they were younger. The teenage shooters in 1999 Columbia High School massacre of 13 students played violent video games. And many mass shootings has been carried out by avid video games players as James Holmes in the Aurora, Colorado movie theater shooting in 2012, Jared Lee Lauder in the Arizona shooting and killed six people in 2011, and Andrew Breivik who killed 77 people in Norway. All of them admit using Modern Warfare 3 training, and as many of you don't know, Modern Warfare 3 is like a game in PlayStation or Xbox. An FBI school shooter states that a student who makes a threat of violence should be considered credible and must give the kid plays video games because it can be true. I'm going to finish this because I think that the studies have shown that violence video games can encourage young people to act violently through the points that I discussed so far. And the points are: playing video games causes more aggression and bullying towards women, also the rest of the people. Violence video games desensitize players from the real life violence, and the many perpetrators of the shooting in the high school play video games. According to this, the American Psychology Association says that the research demonstrates a consistent relation between violent video games and aggressive behavior, aggressive cognition, and aggressive affect. Also, there are risky factors in our daily life. Thank you so much.